what's your thoughts about hyperventilation nystagmus?
So I find this actually a useful test. In patients who have mild gait imbalance and maybe not too much else on exam where you're worried about a cerebellar condition, if you hyperventilate them and you have to do it properly, you may bring out quite a downbeat nystagmus, and that's a very important clue for a central cerebellar problem. And hyperventilation is useful for other conditions. Any cranial cervical junction anomaly, like a Chiari malformation, which is potentially quite treatable, you may get a hyperventilation-induced nystagmus. And of course, even in the periphery, with fistula, superior canal dehiscence, and even after a compensation from a unilateral vestibular loss, you may bring out either a paretic nystagmus, or because you impair the compensation, or in different stages of a recovery from, for example, an acute Meniere's attack, you might again bring out some nystagmus. Finally, if you have any compressive lesion on the eighth nerve, microvascular compression from a vessel or an acoustic tumor, you often bring out a nystagmus with hyperventilation. So one of those funny tests, which actually is very useful.
But to which side should we expect hyperventilation nystagmus?
So this is a problem, and it's more important to figure out that you have it and then look more carefully at other signs. In acoustic tumors, you often get an excitatory nystagmus, like any demyelination, where if you make things recover because of hyperventilation, you suddenly restore function, your adaptation is no longer needed, so it looks like the nerve is hyperactive. So you have to be thinking about adaptation every time you change a nystagmus.